I am free. Today we're going to sing a song about I am free. Brother Bill Clark, are you free today? Free to worship? Amen. Brother Terrence, are you free today? Amen. Brother Chad, are you free? We're free. Brother Keith, are you free? Nothing's holding me back. I don't have those old things on me. Those things are gone.
Part of the grace of God. And I'm thankful for the times that the man of God comes and preaches, and it
need to be. It gets me back to where I need to be. It makes me find an altar somewhere. So we want Brother Russell to come right now and preach the word. How many of you are going to preach with him today?
Where are the virtues that gave us life? Amen.
Yes.
The Bible says in Samuel, chapter 12, 1 Samuel chapter 12, we had a good time playing on ourselves. Amen. It's from the church. Anybody enjoy anything there? Amen. We did have a good time. We did have a fellowship. Amen. And God's loving in Waverly. Brothers and sisters, happy. 1 Samuel 12. And Samuel said unto all Israel, behold, I have hearkened unto your voice and all that you have said unto me, and have made a king over you. And now behold, the king walketh before you, and I am old.
Yes.
And behold, my son grew with you, and I have walked before you from your childhood to this day. Behold, here I am, witness against me before the Lord and before his anointed. Whose ox have I taken, or whose ass have I taken? Of whom have I defrauded? Whom have I oppressed? Or of those whose hand have I received any bribe to blind my eyes? And I will restore it to thee. And they said, thou hast not defrauded us, nor oppressed us, neither hast thou taken aught of any man's hand. And he said unto them, the Lord is witness against you, and this everyone is witness this day, and he hath not found that you have found aught in my hand. They answered him, amen. You can be seated. It is a great testimony that Samuel was able to say that I, from a child to man.
Yes.
And the scripture tells us that the Lord didn't let one word from Samuel fall to the ground.
Yes.
That is an awesome thing.
Yes.
Amen. It's amazing to be able to be raised in the church, amen. Given to God, dedicated as a child unto God. How many have been dedicated to the Lord?
Amen. Yeah.
Amen. You remember, you probably don't remember, but you remember your mom telling you about it. Mm-hmm. Amen. It's about time to dedicate to somebody else. Amen. I got that on my mind today, amen. Lily, amen, to be dedicated to the Lord. Amen. We could pray over the parents, and that's what it was to Dean and Susan to give Lily to the Lord. But Samuel was given to the Lord at just after he was weaned from his mother, mm-hmm. from the black age. And he said, I am old and gray-headed. Amen. It is a blessing to be able to live your entire life as a testimony to the Lord. And the scripture says to be void of offense, and our conscience void of offense toward God and man. And it was important. I want you to see here that it was important to Samuel that his family, his people that he was serving the Lord under, to these people, they was a testimony saying, I believe in you. We still believe in you, Samuel. Isn't that awesome?
Yeah.
Now, this sermon is not about building up a man, but it was a great testimony to be able to believe, amen, in a man that God has anointed to help us.
Yeah.
So, Samuel said, I am now old and gray-headed. Imagine that, son. How many imagine that a little bit? That tells me something. That tells me something. When you get old, you get gray hair. Amen. Well, now, Samuel goes on to say, verse 6, and Samuel said unto the people, it is the Lord that advanced Moses and Aaron. He brought your fathers up out of the land of Egypt. How many of you look back over your life and see advancements?
Yes.
Can you see times maybe that you made some failures and faults?
Sure.
And things maybe, you know, that you were not proud of.
Right.
But every advancement can be given glory to God because you didn't pull yourself up by your own bootstraps.
Right.
You're not here today because you're strong in yourself. You're here today because God has advanced you today.
That's right.
But he goes and recaps the life of the children of Israel for a few years back up to the present. And he says, I stand still, and that I may reason with you, because before the Lord of all the righteous acts of the Lord which he did to you and to your fathers. God never does us wrong. He never does us wrong. You can never point a finger at God and say, well, if God had been there, why didn't Mary try to have been there? Amen. They thought it was 3 days, 4 days, right? Amen. But you can't blame God for anything, because God has never wronged us in any way. Every advancement, amen. In fact, it was just a testimony. It seemed like a trial. It was a great trial and tribulation to their faith at the present time. But they didn't lose faith in the resurrection. But I want you to see that he said, I am old and gray-headed. He said, I've been young and I'm old. I've never seen the righteous forsaken. The Lord himself said to Peter, when thou art old, somebody's going to carry you. Amen. I will tell you something. It's what we are preparing for today. How many know that you are getting old? Amen. What you're doing now, you are becoming old right now. Brother Stephen, Luke don't feel old, but he is becoming old. Every sunrise and every sunset puts him closer to becoming old and gray-headed. And certainly we're not promised life even tomorrow. But God has advanced us. And he blessed us. We have nothing to blame God for. Samuel was a great man, great prophet to the people. And he goes on to say, Jacob was coming to the Egypt, and your fathers cried to the Lord. He sent Moses and Aaron. And he brought forth your fathers out of Egypt, made them dwell in this place. And when they forgot the Lord their God, he sold them to the hand of Sisera, a captain of the host of Hazar, to the hand of the Philistines, to the hand of the king of Moab. And they fought against them. They cried unto the Lord, and he said, We have sinned because we have forsaken the Lord and have served Balaam and Ashtaroth. And now deliver us out of the hand of our enemies, and we will serve thee. And the Lord said, Jerubbaal and Bedan and Jephthah and Samuel, he even mentions himself here,